Yes, student, please tell me what is mean by the relational model?
Sir, I don't have proper idea, but sir, is it related to relational database?
Yeah, of course it is related to relational database. Related database basically is a inspired from the relational model. So if anyone asking you what is mean by the relational model, so it means you are talking about the relational database. But you are talking about the ER model, so it means we are talking about the ER diagram. So we have some notation followed by the ER, that is entity relationship we have. So what is relation model? So we have also seen this concept into the previous classes, and that is the relational model we have. Now tell me any idea. What is mean by the relational model or relation database? Okay. Now let me know what is mean by the relation database. Yes, please tell me. Anyone who want to speak, please.
Sir, the database in which entities are related to each other.
Of course. Here we will not take the term like entity over it. Now we will talking about the relation. So we can say we have the term that is table. Okay. Or we can say a relation. So how to make a relation from the tables, and what is the sense of using the tables, and that part we will see today itself only. So first let me start, and then you have any doubt, then you can ask me. Here we need to talk about the structure of the relational database. Of course, if we're talking about the relation model, so a model which is compromising by the relational database. So any database which is followed by the relational database, and that is to be representation done by the graphical way. So we have the relation model, and as we know, the relation model will be represented by the tabular form. So that's why the relation or the database information will be informed the table. So this is the point we need to keep in mind while learning the database, relational database or relational model. So a relational database consists of the collection of the table, as I spoke you, and each of which is assigned a unique name, of course. So in a database, that is XYZ database, we have the A table, B table, C table. We can't have the two table names same in a database. Okay, in a folder, in a normal Windows folder or any kind of the operating system folder, can you have the two same name the file name? No, we can't have. Okay, we can have, so extension will be different. So that is the only the feature of the operating system. But if you're talking about the database, two name of the same database or two table, we can't have. So in a database, we can have the multiple tables or a number of the tables, but two tables can't have the same name. So this is the point we need to keep in mind. So we have already discussed this point so many times. Now, each table has a structure. So what is a structure? Of course, it's a tabular form. So as I told you so many times, so we presented ER database by the table. So this concept, as I told you yesterday, but in the coming days, I will explain how to transform ER database into the table. So this is a point, and that is would be the part of the structure of the relational database. And now keep in mind the third point, that is a row in a table represent the relationship among the set of the values. So this is the point you need to keep in mind. So you can say in a row, we have the certain values like age, name, date of birth, or and so on. So I'm speaking age, name, date of birth, and date of joining, class name, class number, all these are the field name, column name. But the values which is to be represented by the such column name, and that is composed by a row. So in a relation database, such information is known as a tuple, as I already informed you about this part. But today we will see also this important part once again. Fourth one, you can read out over here, since a table is a collection of such relationship. So this is the important point. We can say a table is a information of the data into a tabular way. Okay, that must be unique, and it should also keep the information into the unique way. But we are not having any information into the unique way, so we are forcing such data into the data inconsistency or data duplicacy. So try to avoid such things. So we are making any table, but as a name is saying that you are talking about the relationship. So we are getting data from two table or multiple tables. So what is the relationship on which we are getting? And that part we will see into the structure of the relational database. So we have the real example today itself only, and we will see how to do such a thing. So this is an important point we have over here, that is known as the relational database. To represent the relational database, what is the thing we have? We have the information into the tabular way, and this tabular representation is known as the relational. So how we are getting the relational relation from the two different tables, and that is representation done by the relational database. So this is a summary of the structure of the relational database. Here you have any doubt, then you can ask me. Yes, please tell me any doubt, then you can ask me. Yes, please tell me any doubt you have, then you can ask me, or shall I move to my next slide?
Sir, in fourth point, what is correspondence between concept of table and mathematical concept of relation?
This is a relation actually, the typing mistake only, please.
So mathematical concept of relation.
Yeah, I will come, okay. So I will explain into summarize where you can say we have the X table, okay. We have the Y table. From X table belong to the student details, okay. And Y table belong to the faculty information. So what is the common things by which I can make a new relationship from these two tables? So I'm just making a relation, that is R. And that is common thing we need to pick, that is by the course, okay. From this course concept, course attribute, we can make a relationship from these two different tables. So this is known as a relation. And now the mathematical concept is relation, so I will explain through the example, then you will understand. So what is mathematical relation? You can say in X table, how many column name we have? We have the some column name, and all those column name are recognized by the field name or attribute name. But each and every value is to be represented by the such domain name. So we have the age, we have the name, we have the date of birth. Now the value which is represented by the date of birth, the value which is represented by the name, the value which is represented by the age, and all these are recognized by the domain. Okay. So I can give this name of the domain D1, D2, and D3. Okay. So what is the value which is to be represented by the X table? So mathematically it would be D1 multiply D2 multiply D3. This is the point. Okay. I will tell you, no problem. This is the point. Yes, please tell me. Now any doubt?
No, sir.
Except to the last point, that is a mathematical concept of relation. So I will tell you in a brief way, no problem. So, but before that, just let me know any note. What is mean by the relational database? Why we are understanding the relational model? So is it clear to all? Now, shall I move to the next slide? And now we are talking about the mathematical concept. So of course we have the relational algebra. So through the some algebraic concept we will apply over here, and that part we will see to the one by one. So no problem. So I'm going to the my next
sir,
slide.
Sir, you are saying, sir, in the relational database, sir, we have tables. Sir, so these tables will be related to each other, like in the ER model we have entities.
Yeah, of course, related to each other.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so that's why it is a name given the relations. Okay, what is the sense of the relation? So I will tell you each and everything by the practical as well. Practical in the sense of mathematical. So you will understand, no problem. But when we have some, but let us understand some theoretical concept for understanding the few things. So relational model mainly consists of the few important part, that is table. Now tell me anything I should explain about the table, or is it clear to all? A table has the rows and column. Is it clear to all? These are common things we have. Now, any doubt in this point, table?
No, sir.
Everything is clear to about the tables. What do you mean by the table? Table means key or data of the information which is represented by the rows and column and nothing else especially. Oh, this is known as the tables. Now, is it
sir,
clear to
sir, ER database will be stored in table. That's now.
Yeah, of course. ER database means right now, it is sense for, this is sense of this one. Now this is the employee entity, that is also known as the table into the relational model. And what are the attribute name? It's a name and salary. Okay, the same we have the its column name, that is a name and salary. everything will be same, but we have the diagram, so I will explain all the concept properly. No problem. Every aspect you will be clear. But we already discussed all those points, so that's why I'm asking here. You are familiar with, right now you are familiar with the term that is a table. Now, is it clear to all? Yes, please tell me. Is it clear to all?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay, and any doubt in the tuple definition, you can read out from here. A tuple is a single row of the table which contains a single record of the that relation is called a tuple. Now tell me, is it clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay, good. So I'm just putting right over here. Now attribute. Now is it clear to all? What do you mean by the attribute? This column header. From this point, you can understand. It could be student name, a date of birth, student ID. Okay, so this is the point. A set of the values that corresponding header or attributes. Okay, yes. if we have the multiple column names, so those are recognized by the student ID, student name, a date of birth, and hostel room number, address, so of course, center details. And now here we have the term domain. Domain constant, and that is known as the value set. Yes, now tell me. Any domain constant? What is mean by the domain constant, and what is mean by the domain? Yes, just tell me after reading the statement, then tell me you have entered, then I will explain. Okay, so any student, tell me your name. What is your name?
Harshit, sir.
Okay, Harshit Gupta. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Harshit, I'm putting your name like the Harshit. Okay, so this your name is comprised by the alphabet. If I'm saying your name is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, are you happy with your name? No, because in a name only alphabets will be applicable. So this is a constraint. Okay, so what the value of the name domain must be compromised by the or consisted by only the alphabets only. A name can't have only the special character or can't have the special character, can't have the integer value and integer value. Same thing we can go through like age. So age always should be the positive. Am I putting the age like the -22? So your age can't be -22. Okay, this is the point.
Sir, matlab data type, apan data type yahan pe define kar dete hain ki positive integer hoga, age hai to character string hoga, agar name hai to aisa.
सुपर सुपर यही वाली बात है कि अगर हम डेटा टाइप की बात कर रहे हैं तो हमारी एज है, नेम है, तो स्टूडेंट आईडी है. तो स्टूडेंट आईडी में हमने देखा होगा कि आप क्या कर सकते हो, अल्फाबेट रख सकते हो और आप क्या कर सकते हो, नंबर रख सकते हो. बट मैं आपको रखूँ 19BAI100@ हैज कर दूँ तो स्पेशल कैरेक्टर्स में अलाउ नहीं है. ओके, सो दिस कंस्ट्रेंट मैंने डोमेन कंस्ट्रेंट में डिफाइन कर दिया. तो सेट ऑफ द वैल्यू जो मैं पुटअप करूंगा, जो नेम आएगा, जो एज जो भी रोल नंबर आएगा, वो क्या होगा, केवल कंप्रोमाइज करा जाएगा. जो बना जाएगा वो किससे बनेगा, सिर्फ और आपके अल्फाबेट्स और कोई भी स्पेस सिंबल नहीं आएगा. पर आपके नाम की बात करूं हर्षित, अगर मैं गलती टाइपिंग में कर दूं, हर्षित 1, 2, 3 कर दूं, सो आई विल गेट एन एरर. ओके, ओनली यू कैन यूज ओनली अल्फाबेट्स ओनली. सो दिस इज द कंस्ट्रेंट.
गॉट इट सर.
ओके, गुड. नाउ इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल राइट नाउ ऑल दिस टर्म? सो लेट अस हैव द फ्यू मोर टर्म्स अबाउट द रिलेशनल मॉडल. सो आई हैव ओवर हियर अनदर एग्जांपल. So in attribute can be recognized by the student name, role number. So we have over here, and table we have seen, tuple we already know this part. Now relational schema. Yes, now tell me what is mean by the relational schema. Yes, please tell me here. Each and everything should be clear to all for going to the next concept, because this theoretical part, definition part is necessary to clear to all the students. Yes, what do you mean by the relational schema? I'm saying
would be the basis on which the relationship is defined.
Yes, of course. Like yeah, of course. So I'm taking a table relation. This table means I'm talking about the button table. Okay, so this is a but relation. Okay, but table relation. A table has the table identity, table number, table company name. Okay, company name, table size, and I can put the cost or price. So what are these attributes? Those are the table number, table company name, okay, table brand, and table size, and table cost, or we can say price. Okay, and there is a guarantee if it's yes or no. All these are values. attribute. Also, it is known as table schema or relation schema. A relation schema means we are talking about the what are the relation or table which are which is consisted by the number of the attribute. So we have a relation schema as we have seen into the so many thing into the our MySQL as well. So we have created a table name and what we have done the its various attributes. So we are at a time we have designed the relation schema. We can say table schema at a time. Now is it clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is meant by degree? If anyone asks a simple question for the confusing to you, okay, what is mean by the degree of in a relation? Sir, we don't know this point, but it's a simple concept. Okay, suppose I have an X relation. So in this X relation, I have the 1, 2, 3, 4 number of the columns name or attribute name. So this is known as the degree of the relation. So how many columns we have? 4. So the degree of this relation table will be the 4 only. So this is a simple term.
Number of attributes equals to
degree. Yeah, of course. Number of attributes, so we can say number of the columns or field name. Same name we can say. Now, is it clear to all about the degrees? When I ask the question, you can, you are able to speak anything about the term. Okay, no problem?
No problem, sir.
So, let me know. What is the degree of this relation schema? ID, free, course, and roll numbers. Now, what is the degree of this point? Now, tell me.
3, sir.
3.
Yes, sir. Number of columns, sir.
Number of attributes, yes, sir.
Okay, so in a table 1, what is the degree?
3, sir.
Sir, 3.
And, okay, and the number of the table, what is the degree?
Sir, what are you asking, sir?
In table 2, what is the degree of the table 2?
4, sir.
Why? Because we have the 4 number of the
4
columns, of course. This is a good point. Okay, I'm just back to my point. Now, what do you mean by the cardinality? So this cardinality, you can see the total number of the row present in the column. Okay, you will see over here. Just see. Cardinality means we are talking about the total number of the rows. So how many number of the rows we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. So here we have the 3. So total number of rows is also known as the cardinality. Keep in mind the word cardinality. I'm not talking about the mapping. Okay. If you're talking about the mapping cardinality, just let me clear to all once again. If you're talking about the mapping cardinality, so at the time you're talking about the, relationship types. That is 1 to 1, 1 to many, okay, many to 1, and 1 many to many. So the mapping cardinality means you are just mapping with the mapping the tuple with the other entities or the table. So at the time term is change mapping cardinality, and number of rows in a table or relation which is known as the cardinality. So you have to keep in mind these words properly. Okay, so I'm back to the my this point. Column, of course, the column means you're talking about the attributes. It is clear to all. Now what is mean by the relation instance? What does it mean by the relation instance? Just please tell me what does it mean by the relation instance?
Sir, number of rows, single.
Relation instance mean at the moment on which I'm putting or inserting or deleting any row. Okay, so if I'm putting any number of the or I'm inserting any record. So record can't be duplicate. If I'm putting the record multiple times, same number of the record. So what happened at the time? I'm just making the duplicacy. And for database concept, duplicacy is not applicable. Inconsistency is not applicable. Isolation is not applicable. So all these part we already discussed. Yeah, redundancy we can't have. It's okay. So relation instance means at the moment you are the database, that is the insertion, deletion, or updation. So this is the point. And we can update, we can insert, we can delete the multiple records or tuples.
So do you mean unique rows or like the specific row you are
modifying? Since should be specific row. Okay, if I need to insert a new record, yeah, specific. So we can do. But if you
example,
okay, example you can say now. If I have the putting the enter over here, the three is the ID of the customer ID and customer name is Apple and status is inactive right now. So I put it over here, but I'm trying to insert another record in the record of the customer, then ID should be 4. Why? Because this is the unique. The record must be unique. If I'm putting the ID 3 and customer name Apple and status inactive, so I'm making the duplicacy that should not be applicable to the database. This is my point. Okay, so at the moment, at the instance, if I'm inserting or deleting anything, so after performing any operation, the record must be unique into the database. So if I'm inserting another record, another customer ID must be 4, or customer name could be anything. So instead it should be anything. But what is the parameter by which the my record should be unique? That is the customer ID. So this is the point. So at moment on which you are doing the yes.
Definition mein it is written. And finite set of tuples. So what is mean by
finite set of tuples means number of the tuples you can insert, you can delete any number of the record, because you can perform any number of the operation. Finite set of the tuples means records or rows. Okay, you can insert, you can update, you can delete number of the records at the time. So what a movement at the moment. ओके जिस मोमेंट पे जिस समय पे आप किसी चीज को इंसर्ट करते हो, रिकॉर्ड को डिलीट करते हो, अपडेट करते हो, तो वो आपका जो मोमेंट है दैट इज नोन एज द इंस्टेंस. ओके दिस इज प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द डेटाबेस. ये हमने डिस्कस कर चुके हैं. ओके
सर इट मींस अ सिंगल रो.
या इट मींस नहीं, इट कैन हैव द सिंगल रो और इट कैन हैव द मल्टीपल रो. ओके
करंट रो ऑन व्हिच वी आर परफॉर्मिंग.
Yes, okay. So on this space, if you are inserting multiple row, so what happened? First record to be inserted, and after the few millisecond or microsecond, new another record to be inserted, and then another record. So it takes suppose 1 minute. In a 1 minute, I am inserting the 60 record. So it takes 1 second per record. Okay. So my database takes per 1 second for the per record. So the moment on which I'm inserting, or on the moment on which the my set into the my database or relation, and that is known as the instance. So here we're talking about the time. Okay, on which time the information to be inserted or updated or deleted. So this is the point. Yes, now tell me any doubt.
No, sir.
Okay, so just I can get a real example. You're talking to me right now. So you are talking to me right now. That is only the moment. But simultaneously, if you want to talk to another friend, you can't do. Okay, except to the conference calling concept. But if you want to communicate to me right now, you can do. But if you want to communicate simultaneously with your friend, you can't do. So this is known as the moment on which you are communicating to me. So that is known as the communication instance. So here we are talking about the relation. So we can say it is a relation instance. Now, is it clear to right now?
Yes, sir. So it's a theory, not an integer value like cardinality or degree.
No, yes. It is not a theory. It is basically, it is internal properties of the database, and which is only maintained by the database. It is not user end. Yes.
Basically, okay. Basically, this is a instance, but this is in the relational database, like in the table.
Right. Yeah, of course, table. Now tell me, suppose I'm just taking real example to just avoid any confusion. You have the 10,000 rupees in your account, and at the moment you want to withdraw. Okay, it is an emergency. You need to withdraw 5,000 rupees. You can withdraw, no problem. So at the what moment you are withdrawing? So you are withdrawing some amount, and 10:40:33. It means 10 hours, 40 minutes, and 33 seconds. So this is the time on which on that moment you have withdrawn the some amount, that is 5,000. And at the same time, if you are just depositing, your friend is depositing some amount. So definitely it takes some different value. It takes some different value, like 10 or 40 minutes. And instead of 33, it could be 32 or 34. So the value on which we are performing operation for inserting or deleting will be different. So the work which is done by us for withdrawing or deposit, that is known as the instance. Instance was completely synonym of the movement. Yes,
now
okay, understood. So this is the point. So now we have the next point, that is the relational key. In the relation key means Abreu has a one or two multiple attributes. No doubt we can have the multiple attributes, multiple columns, and which is called the relation key. So in this case, every record must be uniquely identified. So what are the things we can have the key? And key is what? Key is the smallest unit of the relation or table by which we can distinguish the uniqueness into the our database or table. This is the point we need to keep in mind, and that is known as a relation. And now attribute domains, we can say every attribute has some predefined values and scope which is known to the attribute domain. Like if I to put some value and I forget the value of the is, so by default it will be inserted 10, or it is default value, we can say. That is known as the attribute domain. So we have already seen this concept, and we are not putting anything so into the our database. By default, null values to be inserted automatically. So this is known as a attribute domain, or some values for the respectively domain name. So these are the another concept, to another important term which is to be required to understand for the relation model in VRIB. So this is the point. And here in this diagram we have the summary. But before go to the summary, just let me know the all these terms are clear to all. Yes, please tell me. Any doubt? Yes, please tell me.
Sir, can you go to the last slide?
Last point is saying that
the last slide, sir, with the table.
Okay, I was coming on that point, no problem. I was coming on that, but before that, just let me know all the terms, or 10 these terms are clear to all or not.
Sir, instance is still a little unclear.
Instance, relation, yes. Instance. Okay, right now you are communicating,
sir,
me.
Sir, instance is just like in object oriented, the objects of class are instance. So one at they all belongs to this class, but we can access one at a time.
Okay, yes, this is a good point. You are looking for the object oriented instance. So that is object instance. We can have a class can have the multiple instance. Okay. So that's why
like
I'm saying. Practically and logically it can't have, physically it can't have the multiple columns. The instance means I'm just explaining your answer once again, and the X account you have in the same time, on the same moment you are withdrawing or you're depositing. Okay, no problem. So at what moment we are depositing, or at what moment we are withdrawing? So this is the point we need to keep in mind, and that is known as the time. So this instance in the database recognized by the time. So that's why from this point we have the term that is known as timestamp. If you have remember this word from somewhere else, it is timestamps. Timestamps means we are talking about the on what time or date we are performing the operations into a database. So this is the point. And here in finite set of the multi column tuples means we have the number of the table, number of the tuples, and could be one or two or more than two and three, and so on. So this is the point. Actually in the physically we will see that how do we do. Okay, we will have the practical, so why which we will understand, no problem.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please tell me.
So if we take an example of a table, suppose there are three entities, ID, first name and last name, and the attributes are one and some name. Relation instance can be that ID with the name, right? For example, if the name is Bob and Dylan, like okay. The first name is Bob and second name is Dylan. So the relation instance could be one comma Bob comma Dylan, right? Like
okay, and then relation instance will be the at the moment on which you are inserting. This is the point.
Yes.
At the moment on which the particular information to be inserted. Okay, and if you are the moment on which you are inserting the multiple records, so that's why it is name given over there, the finest set of the tuples. So we can insert multiple, or we can insert only the one. So they to you how many records. You want to perform any kind of operation, insertion, deletion or addition. Like into the our previous example, by practical time we have updated the name, that is I think the Vansika Savani, XYZ name to the my name only. So what movement we have done, So this is known as the relation schema or the relation instance. On the relation, we have certain, we have done the some operations, and it is information to be updated. So instance, it is the word here in the database. Instance means you're talking about the movement. If you're talking about the object oriented instance, means an instance or the copy of the object, we can do anything. So he, the little bit different from the such part. You are looking for the instance word means the copy that is belong to the object oriented programming. But here if you're talking about the movement, only the time. So here's the time to be included over there, but time is not a attribute, so we are not putting on that part, and that is to be also maintained by the database only. So while printing the passbook, if you are withdrawing amount, so your date will be mentioned over there on which time or date you have withdrawn, and by the net banking we can also see all the details. So on movement, you have done the operation that is known as the database instance or relation instance or table instance. So this is the point. Yes, now tell me, since we have the practical and we will see one by one each and every concept, so don't bother about all those parts, no problem. Just tell me any doubt right now here, then you can ask me.
No doubt, sir.
In these 10 points you have endowed, so I have another slide in which slide is summary of the all those points. You can see table is also called a relation. So many times a table is also known as a relation into the relational model or relational database. So in the relational database, let me, I'm just writing over here RD. So RD means relation database. We can have the multiple tables, the T1, T2, T3, and so on, so TN. So all these tables also known as the relations. So we can have the relation R1, R2, and so on, so RN. So in relational database, we can have the multiple relation, and it's also known as a relation or table. And here we are talking about the customer ID and customer name and status. These are known as the field or attribute name. So these are known as the attribute name, status, customer name, and customer ID. Here customer ID determine the factor, the each and every record like 1, 2, 3 we have. And so that's why we have the key that is known as the key. And if we have the only single key, why which we are doing, so it is known as the primary key. And I will explain more detail about the primary key later on, but let me clear to all, key is a constraint on which we can determine the uniqueness into the our table or relation. So you can see 1, 2, 3 is the ID. So Google, Amazon, Apple, active. So all these are the values. Now, what is the domain? So you can see customer name. So customer name is attribute name, but Google, Amazon, Apple, these are set of the values which are related to the customer name domain. So this is known as a domain. So this is a point you need to keep in mind. So this is known as a, and column or attribute, we have already known this point. And total number of the column is known as a degree, and total number of the rows is known as a cardinality. So here we have the one record, that is one Google active. So this is one record, the second record is third record, and it is also known as a tuple or row. So this is a summary of the previous slide. And from this point, we need to look into the more detail about the relation database. Now let me know, is it clear to all about the concept? Any doubt in this point, then you can ask me. Yes, please. From this slide, you have any doubt, then you can ask me. Everything is mentioned over here. Yes, please tell me any doubt you have, then let me know.
No, sir.
So everything is clear to all?
Yes, sir, you can move on.
Okay, now shall I move to the next slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's have an example. Okay, so I'm just taking a real example, then you can understand the concept properly, because I think this could be a little bit confusing. So avoiding your confusion, and what is the necessary thing we need to look into the relational database. So I'm just taking a real example. Now tell me what example I must take. I think it is a better idea to, I'm remembering right now, the fruit example. So can I take the fruit example? So fruit is the mine, this is known as the my table. Okay, and just yes, please tell me, is it clear to all? Can I take the fruit example?
Sure, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So first I'm just putting the fruit ID. So I'm just putting here the F number for understanding purpose. I'm just putting the F name, that is the fruit name. Okay, I'm putting the another thing, that is the F cost. So only the cost is sufficient, that is the price. Okay, and here I can take the what should I do, other parameter or other attributes. Can you help me to design such a relation? Can you help me? I have taken the fruit ID, I have taken the fruit name, I have taken the fruit cost, and what are the other things we can say? Yes, please tell me.
Sir,
any idea?
Season in which fruit will occur.
Okay, so what should I give the attribute name, seasonal or
ripening season, sir?
Okay, seasonal is sufficient. Column names must be specific and simple, so I'm just putting over here seasonal, so this is sufficient, I think. Okay, now just let me choose a different color pen so you can understand over here. So now this is just doing. Now, can we see now the information which is represented by the tabular form? Is it clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now tell me the values of the all these things. So, fruit name, I'm just putting over here 4, 5, 9. Okay. And a fruit name, I'm taking here the apple. Okay. Now, another fruit name, I'm taking over here the grape. Okay, now another fruit name I'm taking, that is a mango. And as we know, in the winter vacation, mango is not much applicable and it is not a seasonal, so I think I should put the no. Okay, so today speaking, so I'm putting over here the no. Okay, now apple is available everywhere in any season, so we can say yes. And this is not a season where we can't find the grape, so I think I should put the no. And the cost of the cost per kg we are assuming, so 100. Okay, these are only the assumption. And grape, we can say under 50 rupee we can easily find out in the seasonal case, but it is not seasonal, so you are looking for such thing, so you have to pay 150. And the mango is again, so you have to pay. So it is not seasonal, so definitely cost will be high. I'm putting the fruit ID, so 4, 5, 9, 7, 2, 3, and just randomly putting only, and that is 1, 4, 2. Now here, just I need to know the entire detail from your side, so I'm just taking the simple thing. Now tell me, what is the fruit? What is the fruit here? Tell me, what is the fruit?
Relational model.
Yeah, this is a relation. Okay, this is a relation, or this is a relation or a table. Now let me know with this example, this point is clear to all? This relation on table, now is it clear to all?
Yes, sir.
And fruit number, fruit name, cost, seasonal, this is known as your column name, or this is known as the attribute name. Now tell me, is it clear to all?
Degree, yes, sir.
Okay, if you're looking for the degree, so of course the degree will be the 4. So I'm writing the degree over here, that is a 4. Good. And how many rows we have? 1, 2, 3. Okay, good. So total number will be 3. Okay, of course. So total number of record will be the 3. So the total number of the rows we have the 3. So cardinality we can say, I can say the cardinality will be 3, of course. Now everything is clear to you, to all right now I'm discussing over here?
Yes, sir.
And 142 mango 300, no. So if I'm choosing this record or row, so now what is known as this part? Yes, please tell me what is known as this instance, part. No, it is not instance. It is not instance. No, this is, yes, of course, this is tuple. This is a row, or this is known as a tuple. Okay, so that's why I've taken the new example to explain the concept. Now I'm just choosing the another thing. So by the different color, so for distinguish the concept right now, so green color I'm taking. In the cost, I'm choosing the 100, 150, and 300. So what is known as in this green color? So what is known as this point? Can anyone tell me? Yes, please tell me. Yes, please tell me. Yes, please tell me. What should I give the name of this thing? Yes, please. I need the proper answer. You are asking me or just telling to me. Yes, what is this is known as? The 100, 150 and 300. What is known as?
Domain, sir.
So good. Brilliant. This is known as a domain. Okay. So this is known as a domain. Okay, if I'm choosing only the apple, so what is this? What is known as this point? If I'm choosing only the apple only in a record number one, so what is it known as? What is known as this one?
Instance?
No. The instance is different thing, and this is known only. This is known only the value. This is only the data value. Okay, what is the data value of fruit name in record number one? So we have the apple. This is the point. And domain means set of the values which are represented by the column name. So what is the column name? We have the cost, and what are the set of the values? Those are the 100, 150 and 300. So this is domain. Domain means we are talking about set of the values. Okay. And so what is single value? We have the apple for the record number one. Now all these concepts are clear to all. Now tell me, is it clear to all with this example?
Yes, sir.
Everything is clear to all. So on this from this point, suppose we have some mathematical concept or we have the mathematical symbol. So we will see. Okay, in relational algebra, I will explain all the concept mathematically. But before that, let me explore the database about the relational database. So each and every concept or each and everything should be clear before jumping on that part. Now you can see F number is defined by the 4, 5, 9, 7, 2, 3, and 1, 4, 2. Suppose I'm putting the another value like mango 400, mango 300, or no, that could be possible. But I'm putting the fruit number of your ID 373, something like this one, and that is uniqueness into the my entire record. So we can say this fruit ID is a key attributes on which I can make the my record into the unique ways. So here, this attribute providing me uniqueness, okay, let me explore to more. If this attribute providing me uniqueness in my record, so at a time, this attribute is known
relational
as
key.
This attribute is known as the attribute key attribute, okay, this is known as a key attribute, and from this key attribute we can say our relation have a one key, and that is known as the fruit ID of fruit number. Now with this word, all these things are clear to all,
sir. What is relational key then?
Relational key, here we have the into the example, you can say fruit ID is a relational key on which we have, yes, the all the records in unique way, and this attribute is known as the key attribute. So what is the type of this attribute? That is key attribute. Yes, this is my point. Now is it clear to all?
Yes, sir, clear.
So far everything is clear to all with this diagram?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's have an example. I have just taken the blank slide and I have explained all the things through a simple example. So everything is clear to all right now with this example. So if I ask any question from the relational database, then you will be able to speak anything. Okay.
Yes, sir.
If anyone having any doubt, then please ask me right now. Because before going to the next class, if you're having, sir, just explain the previous one. So that would not be suitable for me at the time. I can explain, but that would not be suitable because it is totally wasting of time. It is better idea to explain all the concept right now and then jump to the next point. No doubt, everything is clear to all with this diagram.
Yes.
Okay, so I'm moving to the my next slide. Here the relational model represent the diagram. So you can see how many degree we have over here, 3. Here we have the 4 degree. And from these two tables, we are making a new relation, and that is known as the relation schema. So what is the relation schema? From these two tables, we have the ID, free, course, and slot. So you can see all these values. So here, relation model representation can be like this one. So here we have the table 1, table 2, and that is the ID 1, 2, 3. And our name is Rocky, John, or Martin. So roll number, we have the 011, 012, and 13. And respectively, we have all those things over there like course, MB, MB, MCA, and the fees will be in the $100, $150, and $110. So this kind of example you will face or you will find into anywhere. So how to make the relations from these two, from the two tables? So here we have to choose the, or we have to design the relation. And now you can see ID, we are choosing the one. So that is a, what are the important part we need to see. ID is over here, ID is over here. Fees is here, and fees is not here, but we need to choose a fee. So we can choose the fee. So we have taken the fee. So what are the attributes which are taken by the this relation from this table in this relation? So ID, roll number. So roll number is common and ID is common. So we have taken. So okay, these are the two things we have taken. Okay, and in which course fees we need to identify. So course we have taken. And suppose we are not choosing the course, we can also choose the name. So we can also choose the name. So what we need to do? We need to insert another
column.
So we can make, so no problem. So this is the point. But you can see if we have the one column, that is column zero, row number 011. Okay, and ID is 1. Okay, no problem, everything is matching. So this record is also matching, no problem. And this record is also matching, no problem. Okay, and that would be wrong, correct? 01 instead of the 011, it's a typing mistake only. Okay, so in the two, we are looking for the zone, ID is 2. So ID is 2, so we are choosing this one, no problem. And from 3, you can see if you're putting the 3, so ID will be 3 and the fees will be $110 and course is MCA and 013. And respectively, we can put the name, so name will be the Rocky. And here we can put the name John. And last one, we can put the Martin. So what we are doing, can you remember the some mathematical operation where we are doing the Cartesian product between these two tables? Can we say we are doing the Cartesian product, if you remember the words Cartesian product? This relation is done by the Cartesian product. Okay, if you remember
Cartesian product, bata do ek baar.
कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट मैं बताऊंगा आपको बाद में, लेकिन मुझे उम्मीद थी कि शायद किसी को पता होगा इसका. आई एम राइटिंग शॉर्ट में कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट बेसिकली इज जस्ट काइंड ऑफ द मल्टीपल मल्टीप्लाई. ओके, इफ यू वांट टू मल्टीप्लाई दीज टू रिलेशन, ओके, देन हाउ वी कैन डू. सो यू नीड टू चूज अ कॉमन थिंग. वी हैव द आईडी एंड रोल नंबर. सो रोल नंबर आईडी इज कॉमन थिंग एंड रेस्ट ऑफ थिंग वी विल फिल ओवर हियर, दैट इज अ फीस एंड नेम. सो you can see this is the Cartesian product of these two tables. I will tell you, but here I just need to demonstrate only the relational model representation diagram. So if you're making the relation from these two, from any two tables, then how we can make. So this is only the example, but if talking about the Cartesian product, I will tell you with a suitable example, no problem. Don't worry about those part, because Cartesian product is necessary part for understanding relational algebra. So I will tell you in that case, in that part, in detailed manner. So don't worry about those part. Whenever we'll discuss about the relation algebra, I will give some exercise and you have to sort out. Okay, so no problem. Don't worry about that part. But let me know from your side, if you're making a relation from these two tables, now how we are making, is it clear to all? and how to represent the relation. Okay, in tabular way, no problem. And now tell me, what is the degree of this relation? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So resultant relation schema having the degree that is 5, while table 1 having the 3 and table 2 having the 4 only. Okay, so this is the point we can say degree. But number of the cardinality, number of the rows, we can say cardinality value will be the 3. So we have over here. Now, yes, tell me, any doubt over here? Yes, please let me know over here. Okay, now just let me again, sorry, yes. So important terms you have to remember once again, okay? Okay, so we have the same things over here. So I'm not much going to detail part of this thing. So I'm just leaving this part. We got database schema, it means we need to design the logical design, okay? And database instance means is a snapshot of data. Of the data is given the instant of the time. Now this is your curiosity is finishing over here. You're talking me again. What do you mean by the instance? Instance means we have this word. So on this moment, on this time, you are doing the certain operation. So at a time known as the instance. So we are dealing with on the database. So on the specific moment, so we have the database instance. If we are doing anything on the relational, so we can say relational instance. And relation schema means it is considered the list of the attributes. So there is a term you need to keep in mind, and anyone can ask the question into the different way. So what is mean by the database schema? The database schema means the logical design of the design. Okay, you have to keep in mind. But relation schema means the information to be displayed into the form of the attributes and corresponding values. And in the relational database, we always deal with the relation schema, like this example. Now this is an example of the relation schema, because everything is mentioned perfectly. There is no hidden things we have. So we know what is the ID, what is the fee, what is the course, what is the roll number, and what are the 3 S0 MCA and 013 and so on. So these are the data values, these are the domain, and we know this part. This is the point we need to keep in mind. So now the curiosity your curiosity should be clear, because I'm talking about the once again day in time. So on the time on which we are doing the any operation, that is known as the particular database instance or relation instance or table instance. On the specific moment we are updating a table, we are doing anything, so that is known as the table instance. And table instance and relation schema relation instance are same, because relation or table are having the same name or same thing. So there is no sense, there's no difference between the both kind of the useful terms. Now tell me, any doubt over here in these four important terms? That's why I'm put it over here, the important terms. Now tell me, any doubt over here?
No, sir. Thank you.
So please keep in mind, while discussing anything into the class, I always giving the justifiable things, and that should be meaningful, because we are always part of the real world entity. So in the real world entity, we must have the real world thing. So in the real world things, what we are having, what we are following, so we must have. Now see, I have taken this fruit example. This fruit example is a real world entity. Fruit is a real world entity. So that's why I have taken the real example. So whenever I discuss so many things, and I will discuss anything into the class, so I will take the real examples. Don't worry about from my side. Okay, now relational integrity constant we have over here. So in the relational integrity constant, you need to understand the few terms. That is known most important part. Okay, just theoretical, I'm giving the notes purpose only. So I put it over here for your notes purpose only. Domain constant. Yes, what is mean by the domain constant? Can anyone tell me what is mean by the domain constant? We have already discussed for today itself only. That's why I just need the answer from your side. What is mean by the domain constant? Yes, tell me. What do you mean by the domain constant?
Like, sir, in programming, we define the variable like integer or character type. That's
of course.
Means that domain values.
Yes, of course, domain values. Okay, just I'm moving to my example. In this fruit example, say seasonal value, you can pick only yes or no. So if I'm putting the seasonal values like null, or I'm putting your name, so that is not a valid thing. Okay, see, domain constraint means you can put only yes or no. And cost, if I'm putting the cost like 100, HUNRDRAD, so it is not a valid thing because I can't put the any character or alphabet. I can take only the integer value. So cost must be in form of the integer value only. But if cost I need to put only the decimal point, then I can pick. So in the, I can say the cost should be into the decimal notation only. So you can put 0.50. So 100 rupees and 50 paisa I can take. So there is no issue. So keep in mind, the cost should be numerical term. A name can't have any numerical value. Can you say your name could be the Shivam Bajpayee 123? No, we can't say. Can I say Harshit Gupta name could be like the 123 Harsha? No. So that should be meaningful. So in the domain constraint, that defines that what value we are defined, what value we should pick, that should be specified. Here we have the term that is known as a domain constraint. So the term you can understand over here, domain constraint can be violated if an attribute value is not appearing in the corresponding domain or it is not the appropriate data type. As you said so many times to me, sir, we are talking about the data type means integer. We can't take the 2 or two instead of the 2 into integer value or numerical value. So this is the point. So this is domain constraint. Okay, now it is clear to all. Like here we have the simple example, real numbers, characters, boolean number, boolean length, and yes, so on. So okay, so this is the point, domain constraint.
Sir, actually sir, next class sir has been started, sir.
Oh, okay, so relational integrity constraint we will start from the tomorrow or next class, there is no issue. Okay, and there one thing